So many government organisations really are not sure where to start with their data strategy. And very often people know they need to do something. They certainly hear about the value of data. They certainly know intrinsically there's some value of data, but how to go about it is the hard part. And very often it starts with just trying to get a sense of where they currently are, where people are currently using data, where the most valuable data sets are, and allow people the opportunity to not only start to explore what could be done, which creates that sense of purpose and value, but then go and realize that there's some pretty heavy lifting that needs to be done around identifying the data sets, making sure the data is the right quality, all those basic fundamental things that lift capability. And from that point, many organizations can start to think a little bit differently about what the next steps of their data journey are really going to be like and really how far they want to go. Most organizations have developed silos for their data. It's a natural thing to do. This is my data and I understand it, I'm comfortable with it. That's your data over there. Maybe I'll ask to play with it sometimes, but mostly that's yours. There's a natural tendency in organizations to build data silos. And that makes sense because the context of the data, the unique sensitivities of the data, the levels of personal information, they're all specific to that environment or that sub-environment within an agency. So silos happen. It's really quite natural. Federation is a way of thinking about that really quite differently. Thinking about one data field, not necessarily one data set, but one data field which is joined together in a virtual sense or using some sort of data fabric, and one source of truth. So I don't have a copy of your data, you don't have a copy of mine, it's always the same. It's always the same data quality. And the good things about that really are that you can build better governance processes. First of all, avoid the honeypot data set. You can help people understand why it's important to improve their data quality. They get benefit as well as you getting benefit. And you can ensure that you've always got the latest version of the data. It's not out of step, it's not inconsistent. And all of that takes hard work, and all of it requires some fairly serious engineering to be done before you get to do the really groovy and exciting part, which is around AI or around machine learning and about analytics. But the value that comes from that investment in that bringing it together, doing the federation, really does then allow for some pretty rapidly accelerating uses of data and uses of AI. So most agencies want to do AI. Most agencies certainly have heard about it in their private lives, in every other part of their lives. Most agencies want to jump in to start doing AI. And to some extent, that's not a bad approach, not a bad attitude. It's important for people to get a sense of the art of the possible and to do some try, test and learn, but in an experimental mode. So not deploying anything, not putting into operational use. And getting that experimentation happening or creating that environment for experimentation not only helps people imagine the art of the possible, but also gives them a sense of what they can do in their context, whether they're going to use this or will do it in the back office, all that boring, heavy lifting and joining things together, or something a little closer to the customer, and whether it's appropriate to do that and just under what circumstances it's appropriate. So there's a really important element of discovery. There's a really important element of just understanding the fundamentals. Where are my data sets? Because AI, of course, is still a use of data. Where are my most important data assets? Do they have the data quality indicators that I need for what I'm thinking of using them for? Does it have the metadata around it that helps me understand when I create a data product, what sort of guidance restrictions or prohibitions I should run around that data product? And have I thought about sharing? And not just sharing, yes, I'll share, what, no, I won't, but how do I share in degrees with people outside my immediate group, outside that group, inside my agency, across my agency boundaries, or with other governments and other jurisdictions? All of those are elements that can be addressed in bite-sized chunks. Do the least you need to do to begin with to understand raising the sense of awareness and identifying the most fundamental components. Build the case for change, because it's always about change management as a process to take the next bigger, more ambitious steps, more use cases, more data sets, more effort put into cleansing and appropriately handling and sharing, and then again build the case for change to go for a much more ambitious approach. There's a lot to it. Some of that stuff is really unexciting, but really important in order for the AI bit not just to be fun and interesting, but to actually lead to genuine deployment of real AI systems, which really touch people's lives in some way, shape or form. The question for many governments is, what are we already doing in the world of data and AI? Yes to me, back in New South Wales government, we had a period where we were trying to encourage people to tell us what uses they had of AI because we were introducing the New South Wales AI Assurance Framework. And we made it very clear, it's all right, come tell us, come talk to us. And it was amazing how many different use cases there were of AI, mostly experimental and mostly sort of in quiet corners of different parts of government. So getting a sense of those most interesting cases or those most important cases is actually a really important first step. But then, of course, helping government go through that maturity process is really quite important. And some of that gets back to these fundamentals of what are the frameworks we have in place? Where are we jammed up? Where do we have sludge in our system? For those who are into behavioral economics or nudge economics, know that desludging systems is a really important way of thinking about the flow of data across an environment. And ultimately, understanding the assets, understanding the sharing frameworks, understanding under what terms and conditions it can be shared more broadly, provide the basis of starting to build out that current landscape. And then work out, well, what's the level of ambition? Do we want to be operationalizing AI systems, or do we really want to lean into becoming genuine leaders in this space? And for most governments, it's somewhere in the middle between on a scale of 1 to 5, hitting a 3 is probably the right place to be. But testing that assumption and testing, again, whether it's customer facing, whether it's front office, whether it's, you know, simple things like arranging calendars or arranging appointments, or whether it's the back office stuff, which is the lifting, the joining, and taking out some of the drudgery. But sometimes it really is putting things in front of customers. Sometimes it really is trying out something experimental and new and exciting and interesting and different. Not always for the public service, but when you get an opportunity to explore how that might work, it creates an environment where people feel that they can innovate. They feel that they can actually move up that maturity curve. So I have to say I'm a long-term attendee at the Public Sector Network events, including Innovate Australia. This particular event has been fantastic. It's always important to get government industry together. Governments need to see what the state of the art is. Industry needs to better understand not only how to talk to government, but also some of the challenges that government have. All government agencies are at different stages of their maturity. All government agencies have different unique circumstances. And if you just come with a stock standard approach, the risk is you miss the mark. So the event today has been fantastic. The events in the past have been fantastic. And getting to know each other, that networking element is really very important.